Hello, welcome to another episode of Connect. I'm Adrian.
I'm Nick.
And we brought our friend Danielle from our SimpleLink microcontroller R&D team to talk about a brand new device that we've integrated into our portfolio. It's the first crystalless wireless microcontroller in the industry. And that's all done with some of our help in the R&D team designing and researching this brand new technology. And what we've actually done here is integrate crystals into our microcontroller, simplifying your RF microcontroller design. So being a first in the industry and being able to have the R&D expert here on site, we'll dive into a couple of questions here. But to start off, can you talk a little bit about why the BAW technology is interesting for developers?
Yeah, that's a really good question. Really, why, if we look here at this block diagram, we can see a device, CC2652 is what I've drawn. And if you look at it, you have the device and then you have two different crystals. In this case, we have a 48 megahertz crystal and a 32 kilohertz crystal, and then matching used for the RF. And so you can see that a lot of the external components are really these crystals and the associated capacitance.
Gotcha. And what are the roles that these crystals play?
So the 48 megahertz crystal is used for generating the accurate clock used for the RF so that you transmit on the right frequency, so that you meet your emissions requirements for standards. And so different devices can talk to each other. The 32 kilohertz crystal is a very low power oscillator that's used for generating a real-time clock. And the reason we want to remove these and integrate them into the device is that first, they're very difficult for customers to source. You can have pretty long lead times for these. They also take up space. And they are sensitive. So the customers have to worry about how do they build their boards correctly so that it doesn't have too much parasitic capacitance, make it oscillate at the wrong frequency. Or if they touch the crystal pins, perhaps they'll kill the clock and make the device stop functioning. So with the new product we have, these problems just go away. It's all internal and the customers don't have to worry about it.
And the new product, the technology that allows the customers to get rid of the crystals is called BAW. So we said it earlier, it's BAW for those looking, because I'm not very familiar. Can you just tell us what is BAW? What does BAW stand for? How did we integrate these crystals?
So BAW stands for bulk acoustic wave resonator. So in the same way a crystal can resonate if it's excited properly, the bulk acoustic wave resonator can also oscillate and create a clock. The difference is that it's very small, so that it can be entirely included inside of the same package as the CC2652 is.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense. And so with that integration, you kind of mentioned that customers can expect kind of an easier design and layout without the crystals, a smaller size than if they used the device with the two external crystals. What are some other careabouts with this BAW technology? What other things should people be excited about?
I think it makes their development time a lot faster. They don't have to order the crystals. If they run into any problems with crystals, which happens a lot, they've just avoided those. I've talked to some of the applications engineers, and they say that up to 30% of their time is spent helping customers with problems due to crystals.
Wow.
So we've just removed that problem.
It's one less variable.
Exactly. One less variable, one less thing to worry about.
Very cool. And I guess looking back here on the diagram, so this is, I guess, your typical solution with the use of an external crystal. Are we integrating one or both of these crystals with what we're announcing here today?
The BAW resonator is used to integrate the 48 megahertz crystal, so it's replacing that. And then we have an internal oscillator that the BAW resonator is used to recalibrate. So in effect, we remove both crystals.
Okay.
So. You're left with a much simpler board design.
Yeah, totally. Well, we have a dry erase marker here. So if you don't mind, maybe just kind of erasing the parts that are integrated now into our latest SimpleLink products. So that's being replaced.
Yes, all of this goes away.
Okay, very cool. And it's a much simpler design now for our developers.
Yes.
Cool. And where can customers go to learn more about these BAW integrated devices?
So the release product is named CC2652 and is on the TI.com website.
Very cool.
Great. Yeah, so everybody can get started today. Thank you so much, Danielle, for giving us a high-level overview of BAW. Guys, this is very exciting technology. This is the first RF wireless MCU in the industry. that will be essentially a crystalless design, and very, very special to have Danielle here. She's the one who actually completed the BAW design for us. So you're hearing it straight from the source. Yeah, very cool. So thank you guys. Thank you for joining us on this episode of Connect. Again, if you want to learn more about the SimpleLink platform, go to ti.com/SimpleLink. You'll find this BAW product there, the CC2652RB. You can read the data sheet, learn more about it, see some demos, and get started. And as always, tweet at us at Sensor to Cloud if you have feedback or any suggestions for topics. Thanks for joining.